Hello everyone, my name is JMLisondra. Today I'm going to teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So today everyone, my subject will be the lighthouse. So I have now the sketch here. Okay, and please don't forget to subscribe if you subscribe it and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications of my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see the materials on the screen. Consider my brushes, canvas, and all the things that we're going to need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now. As you can see everyone, I have now the sketch, and this is the first step, the sketch, and then after this we're gonna do the underpainting, and then we're gonna do the details. Okay, if you are painting with me, just follow what I'm doing and always have fun. Okay, so I'm going to start now and let's do the underpainting. Okay, so my scene everyone will be something like a night, or this will be a moon here, a moonlight. So this will be a lighthouse on the moonlight. Okay, so it will be great. Excited to finish this one. So since it's night, we're gonna use more dark or dark colors. We're gonna use the blue and then the red and then white. It's purple and then white. There. I just want to create a dark background, everyone. That's why I'm using a dark color romber, just pure romber, because for the sketch, so that I can still see the background. And then the bottom part, I'm gonna make it like a reddish purple. Something like there's a reddish or reddish purple on the bottom part. There. There, okay. I will try to experiment a little bit of colors. So maybe blue and a little bit greenish with some white. There. Let's try to experiment a little bit of colors, everyone. Yeah, you can try these colors. A little bit of greenish. So that it will look like aurora, something like that. The blue. Let's play a little bit in the sky. There. Okay, so yeah. Okay, so I think it's still wet, everyone, so just let it dry first and then we can continue. I can turn back here later on. Okay, so we have now like that, and then we can try this purple again. We can put it in the water. Just like that, from left to right. Let's strokes using this big brush. It's 1.5 inch flat brush. My canvas is 12 by 16 inches, or it's 30 by 40 centimeter. Okay, there you go. And then you can use this so umber to make some dark here. This part are soil, okay? Or we can use the red and then blue and then raw umber. Okay, and this one also. The underpainting, I'm gonna just cover those whites, okay? I think it's already dry here. So let's proceed on the top part. Okay, again, just like a second layer of paint, so second coats. We just have to put another one. Blue and then red and then white. There, okay. Yeah, some parts still wet, everyone. As still, yeah, so. I don't know. You have to be very careful a little bit because some parts still wet. This one was on. Yeah, some parts still wet. It can still, if you add layers, it peels, okay? So I'll just focus a little bit here on this lighthouse. So I have here the raw umber. We can mix it with the purples and then white. There, okay. Yeah. I didn't can add more darks. Maybe we can use this blue and the red and then raw umber. You can just add some darks, everyone. There, okay. We have to build first the tones. So I'm gonna put first the darks, okay? There, since I'm still letting the top part, I'm letting it dry, so I just have to build some parts also. Can add a little bit of white and the red, and then we can also put here the island. Okay, and then let's since we're letting dry here, I'm going to add a little bit of retouch on the water. So again, just raw umber, everyone. I know, I mean purple, okay, dark purple or red and blue. Yeah, just like that. Just horizontal strokes from left to right or right to left. There. Okay, that's it. Yeah, I think my sky is dry, and let's try now to add another layer, okay, because it's not solid yet. Solid, everyone. I don't like it. I have to add another layer. I want a solid layer on the sky, blue and then red, white. Okay. Yeah, and then I think we need to add more blue and red. I'm going to add a little bit of light blue here, or maybe blue green. Yeah. Something like a greenish color or blue green color. Sometimes I run, all you have to do is just play the colors. There. Okay. Yeah, we can add a little bit of aurora ruin. Okay, just a little bit of splashes of this color. In your brush. And the bottom part of one, we can try to add a little bit of light pinks. Okay. Yeah. Then you can put the moon here. I can put some I'll just try to add a bit of light pink here. Okay, I'm gonna try to use the smaller brush, everyone. This. I'm gonna mix for reddish purple. Okay. There you go. I'm going to focus on this part first, everyone, before I'm gonna touch on the on this, what they call this, the lighthouse, okay? Okay, I'll try to add the moon now. So I need to add some more. White. I will use the white and then a bit of yellow. So yeah, here. I'll try to use the smaller brush, this one, the smallest flat brush I have. Okay, I think that's certain. Then we can let it dry. We can now start adding some clouds. Okay, just this red and then blue and then white. There. You can add more red and then white. Okay. Yeah. This is a very cloudy sky, everyone. Yeah, that looks so good. Okay. We can try to add some highlights. I'm gonna make it more reddish, okay, with the white. There, just put it on the side where it will hit the light, everyone. There. We can add more light with the white and in yellow. There. Yeah, at least you can see now that it hits on that part. Okay. And then we can also put some I'm going to use some blue color. I can put some stars, everyone, or some galaxy. So yeah, I will try to use a little bit colorful colors, blue and white. Just like that, and you can smudge. There. Okay, that's very bright. And then we can try to add stars around. I'm gonna use this brush, this liner brush. Just blue and white. I have no toothbrush, so yeah, I can use this one. Yeah, at least you can see now the galaxy, okay? It's now starting to look interesting, everyone. Just a topping technique, or just put a lot of dots using the tip of your brush or liner brush. Okay, that's a one bright sky. Yeah, and the sky looks so good, everyone. It looks just very simple. Okay, and you can see a bit of aurora borealis there. You can try to add more, I think, or try to add more aurora borealis. Okay, I'm sorry, bro. Just blue green, blue and yellow. There, just a random colors, everyone, greenish. Some will look like a letter S. Okay, that's it. Yeah. I just have to blend a little bit here. Yeah, just a random greenish tone everyone on the sky, and it's fine. Yeah, I do not need to emphasize so much for now. And then I'm going to add a little bit of light colors or yellowish color on the side of this moon. So I'm gonna mix for orange and then a little bit of white. Just like that, like a halo. Yeah, I just blend it like that. Yeah. And then we can add more white. And then yellow. This is a full moon. There we have now the moon. Okay, yeah, it's shining bright, and I'll try to use a bit of this liner brush and in yellow. Yeah, as you can see, that is very bright on this part. Moon is hitting on the on this part around. Okay, looks so cool. Okay, so let's start to paint the let's start to paint this the lighthouse. So I'm going to add white and yellow. We can add a bit of lights also here. Okay. Here we're gonna make it a little bit something like a bluish color on the other side. So blue and the red and then white. It's a little bit exaggerate colors, make it lighter. There, and then we can mix for blue and the red, make it much more reddishable and then white. There, you can see now the textures. And then I'll try a little bit of umber and then white. Which will be a little bit of bluish and red and then white. There. Okay. Sorry. And then I'm gonna use now the small flat brush, liner brush, everyone, for the top part. Yeah, you can use this light umber here with white. And then I'm gonna make this part bright, everyone, because it's a lighthouse. Of course, there's a light there on the top. So yeah, I think I'm gonna clean. I'm gonna use this flat brush for now. Clean your brush, and then we can use white and then yellow. So the color must be a little bit yellowish, everyone. Okay, and then we can use some light, we can use some orange. This part we can make it an orange. Just cover it for now. There. Okay. I'll try to make the roof reddish, so red and then the amber. And then you can add some white. And the other side will be much a little bit of purples. There, blue and the red, and then white. Yeah, okay. Yeah, we can lighten more, everyone, because yellow and then white. I'm using now the small brush, everyone. There, I will add a pure white here. It's like doors, okay? Sorry, everyone. Okay. I'm gonna use a bit of yellow. Ah, so as you can see, everyone, that part is very bright, okay? And we can also put quite a bit of halo there, like that. That is shining through everywhere, okay? So I'll be using this brush, everyone. The smallest flat brush I have. Yellow and then red. Some orange, okay, and then we can add a bit of halo here. I'll put more red. There. Okay. as you can see, everyone. Yeah, there's a light there coming from this lighthouse. So I'm gonna put some grills also. I'm gonna put also some grills, everyone. I'm going to use blue and the red. There. Okay, so yeah, that is a lighthouse. Same color, everyone. I'm gonna darken this part here. Okay. Sorry, everyone. We gotta lighten this part because it's so flat. So we have to lighten that part. Okay, so I'm gonna use this brush. I'm gonna mix maybe just brown color with some white. So like that, everyone, to make it lighter. Also this one here. Yeah. So it's now round, okay? As you can see, everyone, it's now look like a round. Yeah, so far it's good. Yeah, I like it, everyone. The painting is, I think it's very simple, okay? Very simple, but it's looking great. I like it. Okay, so I also put some darker shades also on the bottom part. So blue and then white. and then red, or maybe some more umber. There, and then we can add, I don't know where I'm gonna add Iran, maybe here or here, I don't know, so maybe here it should be on the other side Iran. Sorry about that. I need to add some windows. Okay, so blue and the red. And then raw umber. Okay. Yeah. Okay. And then I will put a door here. So this lighthouse one, it's kind of small. Okay, yeah, that's I think look like it should look like a lighthouse. It's great. Okay, so let's add some trees, everyone. I want to add some trees also, so that it will not look like sad, like something like that. And I want to darken most of this part here. So I'm gonna use now the big brush, the medium size flat brush. I have the red and then the blue and the low umber. I can put here something like some rocks.
And then I will now add some highlights, everyone, on the water from the moon. Okay, so I'll be using the small flat brush. This one. I have the white, and then the yellow, and then some red. I think my liner brush is bad, everyone. It's not pointed anymore. Okay, there. Can also add a bit of light color. Just white on the yellow, everyone. There. Okay. Yeah, and then I'm going to now to add also darks on the on this some reflections. Okay, so again this purple, red and the blue, a little bit of white, not so much dark. Okay, so here also. Small island, everyone. Can add a bit of reflections. Okay. And then we have to add also a little bit of greenish, everyone, because of the sky have a greenish tone there. So I have here the yellow and then the blue. It's not greenish, actually it's a blue-green color. There. Actually, this is surreal, everyone. It's almost impossible in the real nature that can happen like this. But I just want to exaggerate things sometimes. You do not need to follow so much. If you're a beginner, then you can follow the basics of realism or realistic landscape. But if you're learning, and you can try to experiment something, that it will make your painting beautiful, okay, colorful and beautiful, or something like we can see different, okay. So yeah, that's what I'm trying to do now, trying to paint a little bit different, unusual, okay. But you can see unusual, okay. So let's try to experiment, make things different and beautiful, okay? Let's add some highlights also, especially in the rocks, everyone. So raw umber and in white. Yeah, you can try the raw umber and in white. I'm using the small brush, everyone. There. And also here. Okay, now let's add some grasses. I want to add one grass, I want three here, one like that. So I'm gonna use this blue and the red and then umber. Just stopping technique. There. Okay. Yeah, at this there's some silhouette of colors there, so it can add flavor. Okay, yeah, and even this one, everyone, I'll try to add a bit of, yeah, blue and in white, not so much bright on that part, everyone. That's still dark, sorry. Right under the umbar. There, I will add now some tree trunk. Tree trunk and branches. I'm using the liner brush, everyone. Okay, so let's add a little bit of greenish. A little bit of greenish, everyone. Not so much green, but a little bit of greenish. So yellow, blue, and then red. Tapping technique. Also here. Okay, not so much, everyone, just enough for, because this is dark, this a moonlight scene or a night landscape. Okay, so yeah, I think I am done with my painting tutorial for today.
Okay, everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.